Jerome, otherwise known as Jerry Lapides, passed away on Sunday, October 24th in San Diego, California. He was 84 years young.
How lucky can one guy be?
Jerry was always the life of the party. He had a billion-dollar personality, and his comic genius was adored by all who knew him.
The room was completely black. I hugged her and she hugged back.
He remained devoted to his family and had a lust for life that was unmatched. He loved humor, music, entertainment, sports, psychology of people, his friends, and fishing.
This is just the beginning. My life is gonna be beautiful.
Jerry was co-owner of the family business Osmond's Men's Clothing Stores and the John Kent Clothing Stores. He bought all the clothing for the retail chain. When he retired, he moved to San Diego to be closer to his daughter Lori and her two young children. I was 2 years old and Lori was 4 and a half when our dad became a bachelor. And he remained a bachelor the rest of his life. He admitted it forever. He just wasn't the marrying kind. When I got the chance to tape a karaoke song with him at the old Tally Hall, which was my favorite hobby at the time, still is, he chose to sing the song, What Kind of Fool Am I? I knew then, and I know now, that song represented a kind of anthem for him. I will never, ever forget watching him in the vocal booth that day singing this song. His twinkling eyes may have even shed a tear while he sang these lyrics. In January of 2010, David and I had the opportunity and gift to spend a week alone with him. Our time together was amazing. During that time, he shared his wisdom and reflections on life. We will never, ever forget it.
Come out of this life.
Exactly.
Make it workable.
Right.
It's as simple as that.
It's as simple.
But it's not easy.
On yesterday, shitting on today. You don't want that to happen to your life. You want each day to be a new day for you.
To have a regret is just so...
Well, it's dysfunctional. And it's unproductive.
It is
and it doesn't solve anything.
But no. It's dysfunctional.
And you can't change it.
No.
Not one bit.
No.
Some wise man came up with that. I don't know who.
Walt Whitman?
No, well, yeah, say a person did something in their life and they made a big mistake. It doesn't make any sense to live with that your whole life. Move ahead and try to push that away and make some good memories to have. Say, for instance, you took a vacation and you're sorry you went. Like that would give you normally a regret. I'll never go back there. Well, forget about not liking it because it doesn't change today. It just happened, and it wasn't what you thought it would be, or it didn't give you that much pleasure. Go with your good thoughts and memories. In other words, don't live with it. Why? Why would live with something that doesn't leave you with a wonderful memory?
Yeah,
life is such that it can't always be what we want it to be. So we accept it and try to make the best. That's all. can't change things that are unpleasant. They
right.
happen.
Right.
They disappointed you.
Yeah.
But that doesn't kill you.
No.
You move on to the next thing.
Right.
You look for something that's going to make you happy.
That's right.
That's a healthier way to be.
What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
There you go.
Yes.
You went there before and you went there again. And it's okay that you go there before.
This is like being at a camp together, like a teacher.
This is like being a camp.
It's like being, except that
we're adults.
It's more luxurious.
Of course, I use the term loosely.
Right, but it is like being at a camp.
We're just people having fun. Whether we're adults or childlike or silly or unrealistic, call it whatever you want. But as long as you get pleasure from it, you know. In order to be a complete person, I think you have to be a compassionate person and an understanding person. But you can feel sorry for the next guy who has bad luck. I think that's a sign of a healthy person.
Yeah.
Because you feel, what's the word I'm looking for? Empathy is the word. You can have empathy and still have fun in your own life. It doesn't mean you can't feel sorry for the next guy.
You're right.
You can have Rachmonis for him.
Which
Rachmonis is Jewish words meaning pity or empathy. Now, life isn't always a ball and fun. There's sadness in life. Close friends die. They get sick. They move away. They marry somebody else. They said something that hurt your feelings. And those things are going to happen. I think a real person, well-rounded, has to be sensitive to all that, those feelings that gives you. But that does not have to control your life. It doesn't have to take over your life.
Right.
You still got to be what's good for you to be.
Our dad was such a magical person with such a passion that was present for all of his 84 years, every single day. His beautiful spirit will be present by all who were lucky to know him and love him.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way. I've loved got my fill, my share of losing, and now as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, oh no, not me, I did it my way. For what is a man, what has he got, if not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it
make it.